is momentum.
Okay, you may have seen this equation here. P equals mv. Now, in this equation, the P represents momentum, the m represents the mass, and the v represents velocity. Now, we're going to dive deeper into what those two terms mean in another video, the mass and the velocity. We're going to focus on the P. Now, quite clearly from this equation, the way that we derive what P is by multiplying the mass and the velocity of an object. The way I think of momentum is as like a quantity of motion. So if something is big, heavy, and moving quickly, that has got a lot of motion, it's got a lot of momentum, it's moving quickly and it's big, it's carrying a lot of momentum. If that hit you, you're gonna notice it. It's like a big steam train hitting you, you're gonna notice that transfer of momentum. Now the interesting thing about momentum is that in the event of a collision, for example, a big thing hitting a small thing, a train hitting a car, a snooker ball hitting a table tennis ball or a ping pong ball, there is a transfer of momentum. This momentum cannot be lost, it cannot be destroyed, and that's a very key point. I'm going to just highlight it for you there. You cannot create or destroy momentum. In the event of a collision, the momentum before the collision is always equal to the momentum after the collision. So if two things collide, a big thing hits a small thing, then guess what? That small thing is now going to have taken some of that momentum from the large thing. In the event of a large object hitting a small object, if the large object is traveling at, say, 10 miles an hour, and then the smaller object is hit, then the smaller object is actually going to be traveling following the collision at a much greater speed because it's so much smaller. Example, say I throw a tennis ball at a shopping trolley, a small thing towards a big thing, that tennis ball is going to transfer its momentum to the shopping trolley. Now that shopping trolley isn't going to move off at the same speed that the tennis ball was that I threw at it. It's going to move, if anything, at a very, very small velocity. I hope that's introduced you to momentum. I'm Mike, this is Physics Friend, and if you subscribe to this channel, you will find new videos on physics and other surrounding areas and topics every first and third Monday of each month. So I hope to see you again soon. Thanks for watching.